Hello everyone and welcome back, and today we are going to talk about the effect options locked and unlocked origin. And you can find this option either in this effect options drop down window, or you can also double click on the effect and here you can find this path locked or unlocked. A few days back I had published this 3D cube animation video where I have used 2D rectangles and 3D cubes, and we had applied 4 motion path to each of these objects. And this video is about what is the meaning of this locked and unlocked origin or path. So let me delete these 3D cube because we have applied the same motion path on each of the object here. So to make it easy, I will show you the same thing on these 2D rectangles. So let me start with this red one, and here you can see that we have applied 4 different motion paths. From down to left, then up and then right. So let me hide rest of the rectangles to make the things easier to understand. So I will hide blue and yellow rectangle, and we will talk about this red rectangle. So if you have downloaded this presentation and if you will try to move this red rectangle, let's say at this position, you can note one thing here that the paths are not moving along with the rectangle. And if you go to the animations and click on this effect option window, then you can see that I have locked all these motion paths. So let's first talk about locked. So after applying the motion path, if you select all of these motion paths by holding the shift key, then selecting the last one, and then go to effect option and just click on this locked, or you can also right click on these animation effects and then choose effect option window, and here you can also apply lock. By default they are unlocked. So what will happen if I will move this rectangle to any position on the slide? The motion path will remain on the same position. That is what the meaning of these locked origin or path. You can also do one thing, you can also move these objects out of the presentation. So during the slideshow they will suddenly appear at the specific position from where the motion path is beginning. So that way you can make a few objects appear suddenly during the slideshow. So as you can see, the delay timing of this red rectangle is at 0 seconds. So to make things more clearer, I will add a short delay timing. So you will notice that this object will suddenly get appear at this position from where the first motion path is starting. So I will add a delay timing of 0.25 seconds. And now if I show you the slideshow, you can see that even the object is out of the slide, but during the slideshow it appears right from the same motion path. So let me undo this. But how this could be helpful for us, locked and unlocked? So let's say if I now unlocked all of these selected 4 motion path animation effects, and now if I move this rectangle, the motion paths will also get move along with that. So as you know that we need same animation effect on rest of the 2 rectangles, the blue and yellow one. As you can see here, let me delete these one and I will show you them by replicating them. So let's say I want to replicate the same rectangle but don't want the motion path position to change. So first you have to look at what is the default value of origin that is unlocked now. Now what I can do, I can go to the home tab, click copy and then click paste, change the color so you may not get confused, and then place this yellow rectangle on top of the red rectangle at the same position. As the origin of motion path is unlocked, so the motion path will also get moved with the yellow rectangle and they will have the exact same position as that was for the red rectangle motion paths. Now before moving this yellow rectangle to a new position, what I want the motion path of this yellow rectangle at the same position, but as the origin is unlocked, so if I will move this yellow rectangle, then motion path will also get moved along with. So what I can do, before moving the yellow rectangle, I can click on origin locked, and now if I will move this yellow rectangle, the motion path will remain on the same position. So now what I can do, I can now just change the position of these animation effects. Like I want the right motion path first. So what I can do, I can move it up and change the delay timing. And then I want to move it up. So I will take this up motion path one level up and add a delay timing. and then I want to move it to the left and then add a delay timing, and then I want to move it down. So now let's see the slideshow. So let's say I want to make another copy of this yellow rectangle. So before doing this, I will use unlocked origin and will make a duplicate and will place it on top of the yellow one. Go to the shape format, change the color, then go to the animation and make them locked, and then just change the position. And then you have to change the position of these motion path, like where you want to move the blue rectangle first. Like I want to move it up first, so I will take this one level up. We'll change the delay timing to 0 seconds. Then I want to move it to the left, so I will take it one level up. We'll add the delay timing. Then I want to move it down. I can also drag this animation effect and drop it right here, and then just add it delay timing, and then the final one. So now if we see the slideshow, that's what we get. So that way the locked and unlocked origin can save your time when you want to replicate the same objects without changing the position of motion path. So I hope you will like this tutorial. Let me know by liking, sharing and commenting on this video. And you can also subscribe to our channel for more upcoming tutorial videos. Thanks for watching.